set of the day!
Let's go!
Where's Flipper?
I woke up this morning, rain falling down, looking for my baby, she ain't nowhere to be found. Long up this morning, oh, rain just pouring down. Yeah, now looking for my baby, well now she ain't nowhere to be found. Well, Lord, I roamed and rambled, cried out a name, went to the crossroads, searching for my baby Jane. Law, I rambled, low, cried out a name. Standing at a crossroads, searching for my baby Jane. Now I can't stand a woman gets cross with me. I'm bound to leave her if she just won't let me be. I'm crying, please, please don't cram my style. You're searching vain for me. I've been gone a while.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Flipper loves your music.
Oh, that's Flipper, huh? Well, y'all all make a old broken down guitar player feel mighty fine.
So you playing around here somewhere?
Oh, I'm playing around here everywhere. Everywhere that is that I can find audience wants to hear a tune from an old beach musician.
We're late for work, but we'll find you again.
Well, I look forward to it. And you bring Flipper with you, yeah? I got a feeling he's a crowd pleaser. Bye-bye. Flipper.
Thank you.
How can the Institute afford something like this?
It doesn't belong to the Institute. It's mine.
Whoa, your job must pay a lot more than I thought.
Oh, it's not mine to keep. It's just mine to use for a while.
A friend of mine from grad school sent it.
It's been a good friend. A guy?
No. A neighbor at the graduate student apartments.
He says, plug it in.
It's plugged.
And say, hello, Simon.
Voice activated. Cool.
Hello, Simon.
Hello, Jennifer. My name is Simon Proto One, which is short for Prototype One. I bring you greetings from my creator. He asks that you always listen to what Simon says.
Oh. I told you guys we're just friends.
Jennifer, I see you have three other adult-sized humans with you. May I meet them?
How did he know that?
Simon, that's Holly.
Hello, Holly. In simple terms, I detected your presence through my analysis of the heat changes, the deflections of wind currents, and the change in relative oxygen carbon dioxide levels in the room. My screen swivels based on voice input information.
Oh, I figured it was something like that.
Hi, Simon, I'm Dean, and mate, you are awesome.
Thank you, Dean. And am I correct in assuming you're joining us from the land down under?
Yeah, you got it.
Toezy, mate.
And this is Maya.
Hi, Simon.
Nice to meet you, Maya.
Simon, did your creator have a thing for Jennifer?
Maya?
Definitely. In fact, their relationship was best summed up by the title of one of Shakespeare's most famous plays.
Romeo and Juliet.
No, Much Ado About Nothing.
Shopping patrol. Anybody need anything from downtown?
I do. Maybe I'll tag along.
Wait. You are gonna meet Simon. He's really cool.
Which slimy denizen of the deep is Simon?
The yellow one on the table.
That's Tom, Simon.
Hello, Tom.
Okay, I've seen this trick before.
Trick? Why, Tom, I'm hurt.
Oh, I'm supposed to believe this computer knows who I am, right? Okay. Where is the man behind the curtain?
No, this is no trick. This really is a supercomputer.
Jennifer's friend from graduate school built it.
So she's got you tricked, too.
Tom! His name is Li Ning. He came here from China when he was 10, and he was a brilliant student working on his PhD in computer sciences.
You're saying some nerdy little gearhead with Coke bottle glasses spent his entire life building this?
Li happens to wear contacts. And he won the Pac-10 all-around gymnastics title. And he's only been working on Simon for the last 15 months, since he sold his internet browser software to Microsoft for $750 million.
Oh, come on, the guy's lying. He's trying to impress you.
Well, actually, Tom, the sale amount Jennifer mentioned is correct. Unless you happen to be from the IRS.
Hey, Freddie. How's probation?
Just fine, Mr. Deputy.
You know, you can practically feel the musical vibes in this place.
You can. That was wonderful.
Thank you. I'd like to rent this guitar for the rest of the day.
Rent? We don't rent, we sell.
I understand, but here's my plan. If you rent it to me for the day, then I can earn enough to rent it for 3 more days. In those 3 days, I can earn more, and so on, or I can buy it from you. What do you say?
I say get lost.
Freddie, I need a word.
When I'm done here.
Freddie. Now. Excuse me a second.
Unless you like to gamble your pool on whether or
Maybe we can work something out after all. How much you got there?
What did you say to him?
Oh, I merely reminded Freddie how much of a music fan he is. Plus, I offered to bet him that the serial numbers on some of the VCRs in here match the Sheriff's Department hot sheet. Turns out he's not a gambling man.
I don't know what you said to him, but I sure do appreciate it.
My pleasure. Tom Hampton.
James Morris.
I'm Jennifer Dalton.
Hi.
I'd love to hear you play again.
I'll just look for the busiest spots on the beach.
Well, actually, we know a cafe with a good lunch crowd.
Well, I got me a stone pony. Don't ride Shetland no more. Got me a stone pony. Don't ride Shetlands no more. You can find my pony. Well, that smokestick is black in that bed, it shines like gold. Smokestack is black now, and the bed it shines like gold. And I can't go walk my baby around no more.
That's what I call music. Mississippi Delta Blues. I could swear I've heard this guy before.
I wish I could stay, but I'm late for a business meeting.
See you later.
Oh, that was real nice. I'd like to hear more, but I gotta go.
Thank you very much, sir.
I'd like to play me off a little Hanging on the Wall.
Vintage Charlie Pat. I believe I can do that.
I woke up this morning, jinx all around my bed. I woke up this morning, jinx all around your bed.
You sure you can do this without getting caught?
That's why you hired me.
Well, you know I'd break a heart if I let it slip away.
Welcome aboard.
What was that all about?
Ah, real sweet, James. Real sweet.
Thanks, Ken.
Hey, you got a new fan.
Oh, yeah. Oh, flipping me a tie. He never misses a performance.
Don't suppose I could interest you in a blues cruise partnership. I get him on board, you entertain him?
I appreciate the offer. But it's kind of hard for me to commit to one place for long.
Yeah, I understand. I had itchy feet myself when I was younger.
I wouldn't mind actually settling down in these parts. My grandparents lived around here. Spent a lot of happy summers camping out with my brother Woody over on the Fabry River. Just, I'm a little unsettled right now. Sound familiar?
Yeah. Lord send me, I know that. One of my favorites. Hang on a sec.
John Brown, look like you armed and dangerous.
Well, I know I'm not in your league, but can I sit in with you on this?
About the key of A.
Let her rip.
Here am I, Lord, send me. Here am I, Lord, send me. Fields are ripe, harvest waiting. Here am I, poor Lord, send me. Lord, send me. Here am I. Feel today. Feels alright. Harvest waiting. Here am I. Oh, Lord, send me.
Mystery solved. He's Mo James, one of the James brothers.
Quinn, I think you're confused. The James brothers were Jesse and Frank. Mo's one of the Three Stooges.
Are you telling me you never heard of the James brothers and their blues group?
The James brothers. Wait a minute, didn't they have a hit or two way back when, in the late 50s?
And the early 60s. My father loved these guys, played their albums over and over.
Well, no wonder they got them stuck in your head. Yeah, that's him, all right. And the brother?
Woody. He was the drummer. They were just starting to gain mainstream recognition when he died.
What happened?
It's all a little fuzzy. I remember it was an accident, but there was some kind of scandal about it. I'm going to check with Tilly down at the library.
Get it?
Got it.
Good.
Not only did he show me where the Maria D. docks, he drew me a map.
Got it. Thanks, Till. See you tomorrow night. Bye-bye. I had no idea this was a local story.
Local.
Woody James was killed in a boating accident 5 miles from where we're sitting, near Charles Point.
You're kidding.
And here's the scandal. Mo was driving the boat while intoxicated. He was convicted of negligent homicide.
No wonder the James brothers disappeared.
Both of them. Mo walked before sentencing and has never been apprehended.
He's a fugitive.
And a convicted felon.
Better call Cap.
Home, baby, don't you wanna go? Was ever saddled on down to the Gulf of Mexico?
We gotta get over there.
Baby, don't you wanna go? We'll see we sail on down to the Gulf of Mexico.
Oh, wow, Daddy, I'll blow my lips out. On a break? How about a bite to eat?
Sounds good.
What would you say to a little Chinese?
You are wise, Grasshopper.
It's a good place just a block from here. I'll stow these and we're out of here.
Cap, I gotta get out of here. There's a guy coming
that you'd rather not see. There's a ladder near the stern, leads to a maintenance barge underneath the wharf. I'll stall him. Hey, jackass!
What'd you call me?
You're Jack Crass, aren't you? My afternoon charter?
I got no idea what you're talking about. Hey, James!
You can't come on my boat without permission!
More or less. You just made a serious mistake, my friend.
Yeah.
I suggest you look at what's in my left rear pocket. That's right. I'm a New Orleans police detective, and you morons have just interfered with my apprehension of a felon. Come on. James has already got a big head start on me.
We could have settled this all much sooner if you'd been honest with us about your status.
Yeah, forgetting that you were a retired New Orleans police detective slowed us way down.
Yeah. The delay was worth it. Just to scare you toy cops out of your short pants.
Did you say toy cops?
Search and rescue. Glorified ambulance drivers.
We can't all aspire to retiring from law enforcement and embracing the morally uplifting occupation of bounty hunting.
It's a living. Are we done?
We are.
It's being real, girls.
Hey, Candy. You may have the gold watch as a gold badge, but if you ever pull a gun on an unarmed citizen in this jurisdiction again, a certain toy cop is going to make you eat it.
Makes you proud you're in the same line of work, doesn't he?
Ow! Ow! What are you using, battery acid?
It's just a little antiseptic. Oh,
don't wipe away the $15 worth of beefsteak I had in that shiner all last night.
Sure to get back to song.
Thanks, Dee.
How's the patient?
He'll live. No thanks to this Gandhi character. I hope you're throwing the book at him.
No, just his walking papers.
We had to let him go.
Why?
He's a legally licensed bounty hunter. Mo James is a fugitive.
Therefore, he had a right to try to apprehend Mo.
Well, he assaulted Cap.
It wouldn't stick. He could have accused Cap of interfering with a lawful arrest.
Oh, forget about it, Jen. I had worse dust-ups at O'Reilly's during happy hour. I'm out of here.
Candy, I'm beginning to have serious doubts about you.
Come on. All I need is one legitimate shot without all these county mounties getting in the way.
See, that's my point. You don't seem to realize that these county mounties have become our greatest allies.
What do you mean?
They want this escaped felon as badly as we do. They have more resources, so why don't we let them find him for us?
Sherry, will you give me an extra order of fries, please? I'm running empty here. So how did this character Gandy get on to James in the first place?
He claims he saw James playing last month at a blues festival in New Orleans and put two and two together.
You don't sound convinced.
Can he put two and two together and get five?
And he was certainly no blues expert.
Well, I know he's convicted and all, but I spent some time with James. He ain't no criminal.
And you're probably right. He just made a bad mistake a long time ago. But he's still a wanted man.
It ain't fair. I mean, he lost his career and he lived for the death of his brother for 30 years. Isn't that punishment enough?
I don't know, Cap.
We don't have the luxury of interpreting the law. Our job is to enforce it.
Sorry I'm late. I wanted to look over the information that Holly Dean and Maya got from Simon on Mo James.
Anything interesting?
Well, here's something. The James' maternal grandparents lived in this area. Woodrow and Moore spent quite a few summers here.
That means he knows the area well, including where to hide. Does Simon have an address on his grandparents' property?
No, the property records that old haven't been scanned into the county computer database yet.
Well, that shouldn't take long to track down.
Well, I gotta go.
Aren't you forgetting something? We haven't had lunch yet.
Suddenly I ain't hungry. I'll tell Sherry to cancel my order.
Didn't he just order a full slab of ribs with extra fries because he was starving?
Excuse me. My beeper's on vibrate.
A message and a thrill.
Great. HQ. Look, this will just take a couple of minutes. Will you tell Cap to wait until we get back? We need a few more details for the report.
Sure.
Excuse me. Since when does your beeper have a vibrate setting?
It doesn't. I think Cap knows more about Mo James's whereabouts than he's letting on. I've got an idea, but I'll need you to stall him for 5 minutes.
I can handle that.
I'm sanctified and holy, I shall not be moved. Sanctified and holy, I shall not be moved. Like a tree planted by the water, I shall not be moved.
What is it?
Thanks again, partner.
Straight with me. Besides, it's better for us to take James in instead of waiting for Gandy to find him.
Get this whole thing settled.
You think I'm hiding because I'm scared to do a little jail time?
Gandy ain't here to arrest me. He's here to kill me.
Got him.
Good. Let's move closer. From now on, wherever he goes, we go. Until you get your opportunity.
Tell me, James, why do you think Detective Gandy wants to kill you?
Because he was hired by the head of Blue Sound Records, Eddie Walsh.
Mo says Eddie was the third man on the boat the night it crashed.
He was just a young, smart-mouthed kid back then, trying to learn his daddy's business. And he was a trifle wild.
Wild fun-loving or wild illegal?
Let's just say he enjoyed the 60s.
Drugs?
Oh, yeah. I remember that night. He offered Woody and me grass, blues, horse, whatever. But see, that was never our scene. Just a couple country boys that loved to make music.
Pure as the driven snow, huh?
I didn't say that. Tennessee boy is always partial to a little taste of high-grade shine and have a close and personal relationship with Mr. Jack Daniels.
How many did you have the night of the crash?
Two. That's all I remember having. And The rest is blank till I hit the water. I always wondered if old Eddie didn't maybe slip one of his happy pills in my drink. Messed me up so bad, went and killed Woody.
Isn't there an even more basic question? If you don't remember being at the wheel when the boat crashed, how do you know you were?
Here's what I don't get. Even if Eddie was driving when it happened, how does killing you now help him? He'd be better off if you were arrested in jail, get the crime off the books, so to speak.
Simon, can you find any reference to Blue Sound Records or Eddie Walsh?
I'll check. 12 days ago, an internet-based financial guru said that Blue Sound Records was in secret negotiations to be acquired by Aldrich Communications.
Would the sale of Blue Sound Records have any effect on you?
I doubt it. See, my brother Woody always insisted we keep copyrights to our own songs. So a sale would just mean more money piling up in a bank account somewhere where I can't come forward to claim.
Actually, the tip mentioned a complete sale of all record and song rights. I could access Blue Sound's computer records, but that would be wrong.
Do it, Simon.
Blue Sound computer records indicate that they own all rights to the James Brothers songs, and there's no James Brothers royalties account.
So that's why Walsh now wants Gandy to kill Mo instead of arresting him.
As long as you're alive, you can prove he stole your songs.
You get yourself a good enough lawyer, you'll end up owning Blue Sound.
Thank you. I appreciate that. But what I really want to know is what happened the night Woody died. Whether I really killed my brother.
Simon, what can you tell us about the accident that killed Woodrow James?
Examining the files, I notice Woodrow's body was never recovered.
Right. They searched for several days.
Morris, could you touch the screen where the accident happened? Mark with your finger around the area that was searched. Thank you. I'm cross-checking the search area with the databases of the National Institutes of Weather, Oceanography, and Atmospheric Sciences. I conclude that there is less than a 1% chance of missing Woodrow's body.
But they did miss it, Simon.
No, they didn't.
Woody's body was never there. Mo, you said he was the one who insisted on keeping the copyrights. Simon, can you do a cost analysis of the value of the James Brothers songs against the value of their possible future albums?
Piece of cake, Tom. Because blues tunes were being recorded by white rock and roll artists with such great success, the James Brothers songs would be worth approximately 11 times as much as their future albums.
I don't understand.
Basically, the songs you and Woody wrote were more valuable than either of you as performers.
Once Eddie realized that, the only way to gain control of your songs was to get rid of both of you. So he drugged you, he killed Woody, and then he ran your boat up on the rocks to frame you.
The reason Woody's body was never found was because Eddie dumped it somewhere else along the route.
So if what you're saying is true, I didn't do it. It's not my fault.
But how can we prove that?
If Morris can tell me the speed and course data as best he can remember, I can do a probability grid map of the course the boat took that night.
We're gonna need all the man and woman power that you can spare.
See what I mean? That boat's like Grand Central Station. How am I supposed to take James out clean?
If they get any closer to where I dumped Woody, you aren't gonna have any choice.
Hello, Simon.
Quinn, what can I do for you?
First of all, I want you to know that I don't like to operate outside proper procedure. However, I'm having very little luck in tracking Eddie Walsh through unofficial channels because I just don't have the time.
Or probable cause. What do you need?
I know Walsh landed in Miami 3 days ago, but I need his paper trail, especially credit card receipts.
Not strictly legal, Quinn. Proprietary information. Heavy security. Give me 5 seconds. Walsh's last credit card purchase was 2 hours ago from Stan's Bal Harbor Marine Rentals, a speedboat.
Simon's map says this is the most likely area. Be careful down there.
too close.
Maybe we should get out of here.
I leave behind the only other witness on a boat that night? No way. James dead. I'm the only one around to testify. My story is the only story. Understand? As soon as they're all in the water, we go get him. You stay out of sight. I don't think James will recognize me until we're close enough to do the job. Stay down until I take off my sunglasses. You'll have a clear shot. Gunfighter.
Too bad. But on the other hand, you should already know the words to Working on a Chain Gang.
You can shake it, you can break it, you can hang it on the wall. Don't have to win a catch it for a fall. Shake it, you can hang it on the wall. Win a catch it for a fall. My jelly, my gold. Eat mama, don't you let it fall. You can snatch it, you can grab it, you can break it, you can twist it. Any way that I love to get it, I have my right mind, I blow this down my jelly, my roll. Sweet mama, don't you let it fall. You can snatch it, you can grab it, you can break it, you can twist it. Any way I love to get it, I have my right mind, I be working down by my jelly, my roll. Sweet mama, don't you let it.
mostly a guy that tries to let his music talk for him. But I didn't want to leave town without letting y'all know how much it means to me. After all these years, I have my life back. I have my conscience clear.
Well, don't tell us. Show us with another song.
Now you folks all listen well, 'cause I got a tale to tell you about a man who likes some sugar on side. He was living with his honey, who was not that big on money, but she did believe in being satisfied.